my pleasure to introduce to you a very renowned expert in the renewable energy business. He's president of Eurosolar. He's also chairman of the World Council Renewable Energy, member of Deutsche Bundestag. Please welcome Dr. Hermann Scheer.
Okay, thank you very much. Should expect, not expect that I'm giving a PowerPoint presentation, because my thinking is, do you need PowerPoint or do you have something to say? excuse me when I change some two words of your introduction. First, I'm not an expert. Because the experts are a part of the problem in the most cases. Because most experts have a tunnel view, and the green challenge can only be met, be matched with a comprehensive view. We need more universal views and less expert views. This is a very important experience. This is a case for science, this is a case for economy, and this is a case for policies. Therefore, my second point, I'm not in the renewable energy business. I'm in the renewable energy policy. This is, again, a different point of view. Yeah? And therefore, I'm going to speak about energy autonomy. And because you have heard us talk by a representative of Nokia, to give one example for energy autonomy, I show you one mobile, which is estimated as the most fashionable today, the iPhone. But I miss one point. If I look to the iPhones, if I look to the mobiles of Nokia or Ericsson or others, why there is no mobile with a PV module in the backside, integrated? Why not? Why not? No, it is very easy. Some years ago, Nokia had such a supply, but they canceled it. Since years I am looking for such a mobile, I don't find it. It's not anymore produced. And this would lead to more energy autonomy. It would, in the present time of the state of development of the technological art, it would not be enough for all usings. If someone takes it very often, like me, it would not be enough. For others who use it less, it could be enough. Anyway, it is a reserve. You can charge it if you are in a cafe, in the sun, or at the beach. You can charge it without cable. There is no reason not to do it. This is one of hundreds of coming examples for energy autonomy, and one element of energy autonomy. Energy autonomy means more. My last book, written and published in 2005, has the title Energy Autonomy. In German, Energieautonomie. In English, Energy Autonomy. In France, in the French speaking, in Spanish, it is published in 10 or more languages. I took this headline as a motto, because the idea was to take a headline for a book in order to create a keyword for the coming change, for the running and coming general change from conventional energies in my definition, and nuclear energies and fossil energies to renewable energies. And this keyword shows the logic, the sociological logic, the economic logic, and the technological, the techno logic of renewable energies. And it is necessary to understand this. The problem of the energy debate, shared also by a lot of environmental institutes, not by all, or even by some environmental protagonists. The problem of the energy debate, looking and even favoring by many who favor renewable energies, is that they think, and you can see this in their scenarios, you can see this in their political recommendations, and some ideas for technological development, that many think, many energy experts mainly think, there is an energy system like we have it today. We should try to keep it, but we should change the energy source within this system. And this is impossible. This betrays a misunderstanding of renewable energies. And each energy source creates the system which is necessary to make this energy source available. It is necessary to understand this point, otherwise we miss the chances. Or we make a lot of very costly deviations and come too early to the point. We have practically one in general on physical, on technological reasons, and therefore also by economic reasons. We have only one decision. The decision is a decision about the energy source. This is the only human decision. After this decision, the energy source, which was chosen by us, decides what has to be done technologically, economically, in organizational, in infrastructural aims. What has to be done to make this energy available for the customers? It's a decision of the energy source. Because the energy source defines the requirements to make it available. And this means if we change the energy source, and there is a big difference in the physical quality of the energy source, and the way how to harvest it, how to win it, how to promote it, in the way how to transport it, in the way how to convert it, in the way how to organize it, in the way how to finance it, then we cannot work with the old criteria. This is impossible.